Hey y'all, you guys, I'm so ready for fall and I need to talk about it.
I hope this is some indication that I'm literally so ready for fall.
Also my outfit. Like I literally have an undershirt, you guys. That's how ready I am for fall, an undershirt with a very fuzzy sweater, my jeans, and motherfucking fuzzy socks. It's like 73 degrees out. But, my tripod's all the way upstairs. But, I will, you know, I'm over summer, and I love summer, but I'm ready for fall. Yesterday, let me tell you, I watched Edward Scissorhands. I watched Corpse Bride. You know how much I love fall? That is hanging on my door all year round. It hasn't come down in like 2 years. But I watched Edward Scissorhands and Corpse Bride yesterday, and I bought a bunch of ingredients to make pumpkin dessert things. I had all my pumpkin fall candles lit yesterday. And now, like, I'm just so ready for fall that I'm basically forcing it. You guys know how, like, wait, this is a pumpkin clove candle from Bath & Body, literally one of the best smelling candles I've ever had in my life. And then this is Tis the Season. This is from last season from Bath & Body. Also smells like I just wanna, it's like a holiday orgasm, if you will. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, so I'm basically forcing fall. Oh, I'm gonna burn myself. I need the big lighter. Where is that? The big lighter is upstairs and I'm not going all the way up to get it, so I'll risk the burn. This is really risky, like my hand is all the way in here. I got it, okay. I'm basically, can I get out a sentence? I mean, this is what happens when you have attention deficit disorder. I think that's what it is. ADHD, is that what it stands for? I don't know. But I'm basically forcing fall in the way that some women, when they're tired of their period, they kind of just force it to be over. People who have periods, you guys will understand what I mean when I say that, but y'all know what I mean when a woman doesn't want her period anymore and she kind of forces it to be over for the month. But so I'm basically forcing fall the way that I force my period to stop when now I'm over it. And so, like, is it gonna make fall come any faster? No. But up here it will. Tis the season to be jolly. So I'm gonna make, like, this pumpkin mousse, which literally just sounds so fucking delectable. Oh my god, I need to tell you guys a story. Wait, change of plans. There's a bit of a change of plans. I'm not gonna be making the pumpkin mousse right now. I'm gonna be making these little peanut butter banana energy balls that I made yesterday that were delicious. Because I'm gonna make the pumpkin, I'm gonna make the pumpkin mousse with my mama later today. Cause the Patriots are playing, and then, and so we're gonna like make appetizers for the Patriots. All right, okay, let's get into it. I just washed my hands, so nobody fucking yell at me. So what I'm doing first though, is I'm scooping a bunch of peanut butter out like this. I'm going to put it in a metal bowl. Yeah, it's about right. And then I'm mashing up a banana into the peanut butter mixture. Into the peanut butter, I'm mashing up a banana. That's what's happening. Let me tell my story. So I lit my oven on fire, basically. Now let me elaborate, because I know you guys are like, so the other day, I was home alone, and I was gonna make a cake. I start preheating, you know, I preheat the oven, and it's like preheating. It's in the process of preheating, right? And I'm mixing together the dry ingredients, and in the corner of my eye, I believe I do see a little flicker. And so I'm like, well, what do I have here? And I, you know, inspect, and using my little inspector gadgets and my thought processing skills and my context clues, I realize that the flicker I see out of the corner of my eye
is a flame.
I might not know much about cooking, but I do know you really don't want your oven to be showing signs of a fire. Well, not even showing signs, it just was on fire. You don't want that. So I'm like, OMFG! And I freak out. I instantly shut the oven off. I call my mom. I should have called the fire department, but maybe not. But I feel like I should have. But I call my mom and I was like, girl, the oven's on fire! And she, you know, like she walked me. There was smoke coming out of the oven. Now, fortunately enough for me, I apparently have some intelligence because I didn't open the oven, which would have caused more oxygen to get to it and it would have increased the flame. I did not try to pour water on the fire because it was an electrical fire and you're apparently not supposed to do that. So, you know, I kind of did what I was supposed to. I just shut the oven off and I kept an eye on it. But what happened was that the heating element in the bottom of the oven, you know, that heats the oven, well, it shit the bed, I guess, and it just, like, decided to catch on fire, and it was all charred and burned. Yeah, so that's what happened with my oven.
I'm waking up roughing in my bones enough to make my systems go.
It's a good song. But yeah, my oven did catch on fire, and that's the story. That's the story. But I was in the middle of making a cake, and the batter was already made. So I had to wander over to my neighbor's house and be like, hey King, can I use your oven? Mine just caught on fire. I actually have the AC set pretty low so that it feels like fall in here. Fall called. She's not gonna be here just yet. She's running a little late. Well, she better hurry up because I'm dressed to impress. I'm dressed for the occasion. Who's got what it takes to be my guy? What it takes to make me shine? What it takes to get me fired up? Don't think that acting cool will get you anywhere. Don't think that acting cool will make you wanna care. I need my and if I get the job done. Who's got what it takes to be my guy? What it takes to make me shine? What it takes to get me fired up? I've been contemplating, but I don't know the words. I've seen that movie more times than you've probably seen it. My mama said that it was okay. Mama said that it was quite alright. What is life, you guys? I don't want to do the dishes, but I should. Why? Why does the earth and her natural lighting sometimes make me look like I'm gray? And not Christian gray. Alright, I guess I'll empty the dishwasher because I'm a good daughter. When I taste tequila. Aren't those guys just like so nice? I don't know anything about them, but every time I see them, they're always smiling. Don't wanna be an American idiot. When I taste tequila. I don't know any other songs by them. Shake it for the young man, shake it for the hunk down, for the redneck, drink it till the break it down. Shake it for the wrong guy, shake country girl, shake it for me, girl. Here's what happens, is I film a video and I don't edit it for a few weeks, and then when I go back to edit it, I find little things like that, little trinkets that I left behind for future me to see, and I realize that this is like, must be how people perceive me, like what? What was that? It was like a little outburst. Luke Bryan is a dilf. You know who else is such a fucking dilf? And I've said it before and I'll say it again. Sunday fun day, go Pats, Tom Brady. Now I know, he's not with the Patriots anymore. Well, a girl can dream. And he's still, no matter where he is, even if he is all of a sudden working with NASA and Elon Musk, that motherfucker will always be a dilf. And I'm scared of his wife. But listen, girl, I just have to admit, your husband is a dad. Is a dad I'd like to football around with. Shake it for the girl, shake it for the honky tonk, for the redneck swinging till the break of dawn. Since I'm doing the dishes, that means that I'm a hard worker in the American society, and I should be getting paid. I'm doing manual labor. Run me my money. Country girl, shake it for me, girl. I'm gonna play that song. It's a good song. Bomb bada bomb ba bomb ba bomb bomb bada bang bada bang ba bang ba bang bang. Hit 'em with it! Got a little boom in my big truck. Gonna open up the doors and turn it up. Woo! Get up my daddy's tractor. This song is so good! Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me.
shake it for me.
Physically sick to my stomach over how good that song is.
You and me, let's lose it. The way you're dancing, swaying too. Hey, get in there.
Country girl, shake it for me. Guys, why do these not look like my arms? They look like someone's reaching out from behind me. Okay. Oh, my dryer broke last night. Courtesy of me needing to do some laundry.
Club going up on a Tuesday, but it's a Wednesday.
And I need to show everybody something, so...
It looks like I'm wearing a muumuu. It's literally down to my knees! It looks like I just had sex with
Gronkowski.
And he gave me his clothes. He's like, here, throw that on. Let's get you out of here. And this is what he gave me, and I was like, thanks for the great time, and I walk out of his $1 million fucking mansion looking, like, guys, it's a long sleeve. But, you guys, it's like great because I don't have to wear pants. I'm not wearing pants right now. And I don't need to.
Ring, ring, hello?
I'm waiting until October to watch Nightmare Before Christmas. Let me talk to y'all about that for a second. Any Tim Burton movie that was stop motion, Nightmare Before Christmas, is Coraline by him? I don't know, but Coraline, Corpse Bride, terrified of those movies, because Wallace and Gromit, basically any Clay stop motion cinema, really, I could never watch them because they made me feel like really scared. They just made me feel uneasy. But I decided that like I'm not gonna be a baby anymore, and I'm gonna do it, and I'm gonna watch them, and I'm gonna like them. I watched The Corpse Bride the other day. I wasn't fully paying attention, but from what I saw of it, it was great and I enjoyed it. And I didn't get nauseous or I got a little scared. But that's something I need to work on. But I didn't get nauseous and it was great. This is Halloween, this is Halloween. I recently just watched Scream for the first time ever. I know, I'm late to the party, but guess what? The party's still bumping and pumping and grooving, raising the roof. And so I might be late to the party, but I still arrived. That is such a good fucking movie. And let me tell you why. It's because I'm sick and I'm mentally ill and I have a lot of issues. And so when I saw those two psycho killer, when I saw those two psycho killers, you know, Scooby Dooby Doo and Johnny Depp look alike, I really felt my heart flutter, like a little butterfly in my chest, and she was like, let me out. And so I really enjoyed the movie because I was attracted to those two. Emma Chamberlain! She looks so good. Can someone tell me how to self-publish a book? My banana is gone. I'm gonna go leave it on the floor so someone can trip over it like a little cartoon. And I can get a little giggle. A little laugh in my otherwise laughless life. So what, we get drunk. So what, we smoke weed. We're just having fun and we don't care who sees. So what, we go out. That's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free. Hey, can we talk about Ed Sheeran? Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it, Ryan Link. I've been filming for 17 minutes and I'm gonna go.